U.S. industrial robot installations actually reached record high levels in the second quarter of 2022, as we continue to see strong demand driven by the post-COVID wave of digitization. In addition to the short-term drivers of demand, these record sales are driven by longer-term tailwinds, such as rapid technological advancements in robotics and AI. For example, in a medical setting, artificial intelligence can now be used in a number of transformative ways. These include things such as disease diagnostics or managing hospital workflows. With respect to other robotic segments, we have been observing an interesting trend where the growth in service robots has outpaced that of industrial robots. This is causing a shift to occur as the robotics industry transitions into a services era. In particular, the sales of professional service robots, such as those used for delivery or healthcare applications, are on track to overtake industrial robots as soon as the middle of 2023. More than a third of all professional service robot applications in 2021 were found within the transportation and logistics industries, such as for the transportation of goods in factories, while about 16% were found in hospitality for things such as food and drinks preparation. Other popular types of professional service robots are surgical robots, flow cleaning and disinfection robots, and robots used within agriculture. Globally, robotic system revenues are expected to grow at a compound annual growth rate of 5% between 2022 and 2026. In terms of leading industries by revenue, the electric and electronics industry actually overtook car producers as the most important plant for industrial robotics manufacturers within the last 5 years. Revenue increased by an estimated 60% from 2016 to 2021. In the automotive industry, sales amounted to $2.2 billion in 2021, with expectations for this number to grow to $2.8 billion in 2026. Geographically, the highest demand for industrial robots comes from China, Japan, and Germany, with an estimated combined revenue of over $3.4 billion in 2022. Robots are beginning to make their mark in other sectors of the economy as well. Chemical products are currently seeing the fastest growth in installations. This is followed by the food industry and metal and machinery. Technological advancements in robotics and artificial intelligence are making robotics more useful and practical. For example, FANUC's R2000i series launched in 2015 with the price of $100,000. It could handle almost any gripper or welding gun. FANUC has now reduced the size and weight of the mechanical unit while implementing state-of-the-art motion control technology. Looking forward, in 2027, we expect the launch of Tesla's Optimus humanoid robot at a significantly lower cost of less than $20,000. According to the company, it will be equipped with advanced human-like qualities, such as processing visual data and making decisions in real time based on multiple sensor inputs. The average unit price of industrial robots in the United States has fallen by almost 30% since 2004. Robot features and functionality continue to increase while maintaining decreasing costs. In contrast, the total worker compensation for the manufacturing industry over the same period has risen by more than 48%. This is the result of a combination of short-term macroeconomic conditions as well as more long-term structural factors. The challenges of finding enough workers since the pandemic has driven companies to buy more robots. Similarly, a low U.S. unemployment rate pushed up total worker compensation, causing manufacturers to seek cost effectiveness by turning to robots to fulfill orders. Inflation and labor shortages have also driven wages higher in many sectors, incentivizing companies to invest in automation. Alternatively, output and productivity are a main consideration for manufacturers. If we compare the change in average weekly output of some of the largest automotive manufacturers to that of Tesla over recent years, we see that in 2021, Tesla produced the highest average number of cars per week among its peers. Tesla was able to achieve this by allocating one robot to every four employees, which is also the highest robot-to-employee ratio among its peers. Robotics as a service is an emerging trend, which along with the declining cost of robotics is helping to make robots even more affordable. The market is seeing rising demand among small and medium enterprises that cannot afford to buy a robot upfront. Robotics as a service subscriptions offer a good entry point here. Robotics as a service floor cleaning robots can be leased for around $500 a month. This is close to 5 times cheaper than the average US monthly cleaning salary. Because of its significant cost advantage and appeal to a wider spectrum of companies, the global robotics as a service market is expected to grow to $44 billion by 2028 at a constant annual growth rate of over 16%. The drone delivery market is another example of a market which is fueled by the exploding growth in e-commerce. It is expected to reach over $13 billion by 2028. Along with incumbent parcel delivery service companies like UPS and FedEx, mega-cap tech companies like Amazon and Google have already announced or plan to announce commercial launches of their drone delivery services. Another area where we can witness the growth in professional service robots is the medical and surgical robot market. These areas are becoming increasingly essential to healthcare. The value of the medical market is set to quadruple by 2030, reaching $44 billion, while the surgical robot market will be almost double to $120 billion.